Hey, shalom everybody. Big Daddy Biggs here, productreviewdude.com, and this is Through the Bible in a Year with Big Daddy Biggs. I appreciate you being here, as today we're reading the scriptures from the Tree of Life version of the Bible, Numbers chapter 7 and Numbers chapters 8. And again, this is the Tree of Life version of the Bible. Without any further ado, let's get started. Offerings of Tribal Princes. When Moses finished setting up the tabernacle, he anointed and consecrated it and all its implements, the altar and all its utensils, and he anointed and consecrated them. Then the princes of Israel, heads of their ancestral houses, they were tribal princes in charge over those who were numbered, gave offerings. They brought as their gift before Adonai 6 covered carts and 12 oxen, a cart from every two princes and an ox from every one of them. They presented them before the tabernacle. Adonai spoke to Moses, saying, "Accept these from them to use in the service of the tent of meeting. Give them to the Levites to use as each man's work requires." So Moses took the carts and the oxen and gave them to the Levites. He gave two carts and four oxen to the sons of Gershon, as their work required, and four carts and eight oxen to the sons of Merari, as their work required, under the direction of Ithamar, son of Aaron, the Kohen. But to the sons of Kohath he did not give any, because their responsibility was carrying the holy items on their shoulders. When the altar was anointed, the princes brought their dedication offerings and presented them before the altar. For Adonai had said to Moses, "Each day one of the princes is to bring his offering for the altar's dedication." Bringing his offering on the first day was Nahshon, son of Amminadab, from the tribe of Judah. His offering was one silver plate weighing 130 shekels, one silver basin weighing 70 shekels, by the shekel of the sanctuary, both of them filled with fine flour, mixed with oil as a grain offering, one ladle of 10 shekels of gold filled with incense, one young bull from the herd, one ram, one male lamb a year old as a burnt offering, one male goat as a sin offering, and two oxen, five rams, five male goats, and five male lambs 1 year old to be sacrificed as a fellowship offering. This was the offering of Nahshon, son of Amminadab. On the second day, Nathanael, son of Zuar, prince of Issachar, brought his offering. The offering he brought was one silver plate weighing 130 shekels, one silver basin weighing 70 shekels, according to the shekel of the sanctuary, both filled with fine flour mixed with oil for a grain offering, one gold ladle of 10 shekels filled with incense, one bull, young bull, one ram, and one male lamb, 1 year old, for a burnt offering, one male goat for a sin offering, and two oxen, five rams, five male goats, and five male lambs, 1 year old, to be sacrificed as a fellowship offering. This was the offering of Nathanael, son of Zuar. On the third day was the prince of the sons of Zebulun, Eliab, son of Helon. His offering was one silver plate weighing 130 shekels, one silver basin weighing 70 shekels, both according to the shekel of the sanctuary, both filled with fine flour, mixed with oil for a grain offering, one of 10 shekels of gold filled with incense, one young bull, one ram, and one male lamb, a year old, for a burnt offering, one male goat for a sin offering, two oxen, five rams, five male goats, and five male lambs 1 year old to be sacrificed as a fellowship offering. This was the offering of Eliab, son of Helon. On the fourth day was the prince of the sons of Reuben, Eliezer, son of Shedeur. His offering was one silver plate weighing 130 shekels, one silver basin weighing 70 shekels, according to the shekel of the sanctuary, both filled with fine flour mixed with oil, for a grain offering, one ladle of 10 shekels of gold filled with incense, one bull, one young bull, one ram, one male lamb, a year old for burnt offering, one male goat for a sin offering, and two oxen, five rams, five male goats, and five lambs, 5 male lambs a year old to be sacrificed as a fellowship offering. This was the offering of Eleazar, son of Shedeur. On the 5th day was the prince of the sons of Simeon, Shelumiel, son of Zurishaddai. His offering was one silver plate weighing 130 shekels, one silver basin weighing 70 shekels according to the shekel of the sanctuary, both filled with fine flour mixed with oil for a grain offering, one ladle of 10 shekels of filled gold with incense, one young bull, one ram, one male lamb a year old for a burnt offering, one male goat for a sin offering, and two oxen, 5 rams, 5 male goats, and 5 male lambs a year old to be sacrificed as a fellowship offering. This was the offering of Shelumiel, son of Zurishaddai. One on the 6th day of the prince was the prince of the sons of Gad, Eliasaph, son of Deuel. His offering was one silver plate weighing 130 shekels, one silver basin weighing 70 shekels according to the shekel of the sanctuary, both filled with fine flour mixed with oil for a grain offering, one ladle of 10 shekels of gold filled with incense, one young bull, one ram, and one male lamb a year old for a burnt offering, one male goat for a sin offering, and two oxen, 5 rams, 5 male goats, and 5 male lambs a year old to be sacrificed as a fellowship offering. This was the offering of Eliasaph, son of Deuel. On the 7th day was the prince of the sons of Ephraim, Elishama, son of Ammihud. His offering was one silver plate weighing 130 shekels, one silver basin weighing 70 shekels, according to the shekel of the sanctuary, both filled with fine flour, mixed with oil for a grain offering, one ladle of 10 shekels of gold filled with incense, one young bull, one ram, one male lamb a year old for a burnt offering, one male goat for a sin offering, and two oxen, 5 rams, 5 male goats, and 5 male lambs a year old to be sacrificed as a fellowship offering. This was the offering of Elishama, son of Ammihud. On the 8th day was the prince of Manasseh, Gamliel, son of Pedazur. His offering was one silver plate weighing 130 shekels, one silver basin weighing 70 shekels, according to the shekel of the sanctuary, both filled with fine flour, mixed with oil for a grain offering, one ladle of 10 shekels of gold filled with incense, one young bull, one ram, one male lamb a year old for a burnt offering, one male goat for a sin offering, and two oxen, 5 rams, 5 male goats, and 5 lambs a year old to be sacrificed as a fellowship offering. This was the offering of Gamliel, son of Pedazur. On the 9th day was the prince of the sons of Benjamin, Abidan, son of Gideoni. His offering was one silver plate weighing 130 shekels, one silver basin weighing 70 shekels according to the shekel of the sanctuary, both filled with fine flour mixed with oil for a grain offering, one ladle of 10 shekels of gold filled with incense, one young bull, one ram, and one male lamb a year old for a burnt offering, and one male goat for a sin offering, and two oxen, 5 rams, 5 male goats, and 5 lambs a year old to be sacrificed as a fellowship offering. This was the offering of Abidan, son of Gideoni. On the 10th day came the prince of the sons of Dan, Ahiezer, son of Ammishaddai. His offering was one silver plate weighing 130 shekels, one silver basin weighing 70 shekels, according to the shekel of the sanctuary, both filled with fine flour mixed with oil for a grain offering, one ladle of 10 shekels of gold filled with incense, one young bull, one ram, one male lamb a year old as a burnt offering, one male goat for a sin offering, and two oxen, 5 rams, 5 male goats, and 5 male lambs a year old to be sacrificed as a fellowship offering. This was the offering of Ahiezer, son of Ammishaddai. On the 11th day came the prince of the sons of Asher, Pagiel, son of Ochran. His offering was one silver plate weighing 130 shekels, one silver basin weighing 70 shekels according to the sanctuary, according to the shekel of the sanctuary, both filled with fine flour mixed with oil for a grain offering. One ladle of 10 shekels of gold filled with incense, one young bull, one ram, one male lamb a year old as a burnt offering, one male goat for a sin offering, and two oxen, five rams, five male goats, and five male lambs a year old to be sacrificed as a fellowship offering. This was the offering of Pagiel, son of Ochran. On the 12th day came the prince of the sons of Naphtali, Ahira, son of Enan. Excuse me. His offering was one silver plate weighing 130 shekels, one silver basin weighing 70 shekels according to the shekel of the sanctuary, both filled with fine flour mixed with oil for a grain offering, one ladle of 10 shekels of gold filled with incense, one young bull, one ram, one male lamb a year old for a burnt offering, one male goat for a sin offering, and two young bulls, five rams, five male goats, and five male lambs a year old to be sacrificed as a fellowship offering. This was the offering of Ahira, son of Enan. This was the dedication offering from the princes of Israel for the day when the altar was to be anointed, 12 silver plates, 12 silver basins, 12 gold ladles. Each silver plate was 130 shekels. Each silver basin was of 70 shekels. Altogether, the silver utensils weighed 2,400 shekels according to the shekel of the sanctuary. The 12 gold ladles filled with incense each weighed 10 shekels by the shekel of the sanctuary. Altogether, the gold ladles totaled 120 shekels. The total of the livestock for the burnt offering was 12 young bulls, 12 rams, and 12 male lambs, each a year old, along with their grain offering. 12 male goats were sin offerings. The total number of livestock used for sacrifice of fellowship offerings was 24 oxen, 60 rams, 60 male goats, and 60 male lambs a year old. These were the dedicatory offerings for the altar after it was anointed. When Moses entered the tent of meeting to speak with Adonai, he heard the voice speaking to him from above the atonement cover atop the Ark of the Testimony between the cherubim, so he spoke with him. Numbers chapter 8. Dedication of the Levites. Adonai spoke to Moses, saying, "Speak to Aaron and say to him, when you erect the lamps, the seven lamps are to illuminate the area in front of the menorah." Aaron did so. He erected the lamps facing forward, so they illuminated the area in front of the menorah, just as Adonai had commanded Moses. Now, this is how the menorah was made: hammered gold from its base to its blossoms, just as was the pattern that Adonai had shown to Moses. So he made the menorah. Again, Adonai spoke to Moses, saying, "Take the Levites from among Bnei Yisrael and ceremonially cleanse them. This is what you must do to them to make them clean. Sprinkle the purifying water on them, then have them shave their whole bodies and wash their clothes, thus purifying themselves. Then they are to take a young bull with its grain offering of fine flour mixed with oil, plus a second young bull for a sin offering. Bring the Levites before the tent of meeting and gather the whole community of Bnei Yisrael. Bring the Levites before Adonai. Bnei Yisrael will lay their hands on the Levites, and Aaron will present the Levites before Adonai as a wave offering from Bnei Yisrael. Then they may go about the work of the service of Adonai. The Levites are to lay their hands on the heads of the bulls, use one for a sin offering and the other for a burnt offering to Adonai to make atonement for the Levites. Have the Levites stand before Adonai and his sons and present them as a wave offering to Adonai. In this way you are to set apart the Levites from Bnei Yisrael to be mine. After you have purified them and presented them as a wave offering, the Levites will come to do their work in the tent of meeting. For they are the ones from among Bnei Yisrael given to me in the place of all the first from the wombs of Bnei Yisrael. I have taken them for myself. For every firstborn among Bnei Yisrael is mine, whether human or animal. On the day I struck down the firstborn of the land of Egypt, I sanctified them for myself. So I am taking the Levites in place of the firstborn of Bnei Yisrael. And I am giving the Levites as a gift to Aaron and his sons from among Bnei Yisrael to do the work on behalf of Bnei Yisrael in the tent of meeting and to make atonement for them so that there would be no plague among them for coming too close to the sanctuary. So Moses, Aaron, and the entire community of Bnei Yisrael did so with the Levites, all that Adonai had commanded Moses regarding the Levites, so Bnei Yisrael did to them. The Levites also purified themselves from sin and washed their clothes. Aaron presented them as a wave offering before Adonai, and he made atonement for them to purify them. After that, the Levites came to do their task before Aaron and his sons in the tent of meeting, just as Adonai had commanded Moses concerning the Levites. Adonai spoke to Moses, saying, "This is for the Levites. Men 25 years old and upward are to present themselves for service to work in the tent of meeting. But at the age of 50, he is to retire from his service and work no longer. He may assist his brothers in the tent of meeting to do their duties, but he himself will no longer do the work. Thus, you are to assign to the Levites their responsibilities." Appreciate you being here. Hope you can join me next time. We'll be here again tomorrow. And I know God loves you. I love you. May you have a blessed day. Bye-bye.